You guys aren't tired for me now, are you? I mean, you've been singing, you had a lunch, you did a big meet and greet.
We're just getting warmed up. You know, this is, for the past 10 years, we've been taking a break from this. So we're refreshed, ready to go, ready to get back into it. This was a great morning, full of a lot of energy from the crowd. The meet and greet went really well. So, you know, this is just the beginning of a great day.
Yeah. So how excited are you guys that next week it is, right, that the big album, you guys are going to be going on tour. How excited are you guys to be back together?
It's extremely exciting. I mean, the fans are great, and we have, you know, new music, and, you know, we just have so much fun recording together and performing together. And I mean, this is really the best job anybody could ever hope for.
Let me ask one thing. I think a lot of people are like, why did they stop? Was it because it was the boy band craze and it wasn't hot anymore? Why did you guys take this 10-year hiatus?
I think a lot of it had to do with just, you know, personal lives. We just each had different things we wanted to accomplish in our lives individually. We each had lives outside of the group that we wanted to pay more attention to. Because when you're on tour, you're gone all the time. I mean, you're on the road. So it puts a strain on your personal life. And, you know, sometimes you have to pay attention to those areas. And, you know, I think it was good for us, honestly, because we were all able to go off and do different things, grow as performers, grow as individuals, and then when we came back together, we're that much stronger, that much more confident, that much more capable. So I think in the long run, while at the time it was like, oh, 10 years, that's a long break, now it seems like, you know, it was definitely the right choice for us.
You know, when I was listening to you guys some of the guests here were asking questions, and then even when I was looking back at our interview, you mentioned it twice now that you said something to the effect of, we've taken our lumps. When you say that, what do you mean by that? Do you guys feel like you guys have sometimes gotten a bad rap? Because I'm going to be honest with you, when I look at some of the critiques and reviews over the years, like when I was doing my research, of course, I'm biased because you guys are our Cincinnati guys, and I love you guys. But people are hard on you guys. So what do you mean by that when you say we've taken our lumps, you know, you get sick of that?
There's
sort of
a misconception about our group that we were put together, manufactured. We just walked into a record company and they just signed us. And, you know, it was a sort of a fabricated kind of thing rather than, you know, building ourselves organically. These guys all went to performing arts high school. You know, these guys are musicians. You know, we arranged stuff a cappella. We went in and got signed at a Boys to Men, after being at a Boys to Men concert, who's a tremendous vocal group, who signed to Motown, and we got signed to Motown. I mean, you know, so, you know, Backstreet Boys, NSYNC, groups like that came out, and during that time, people knew that they were put together. And so they assumed, because we're basically four white guys that sing harmony and do R&B pop music, that we were sort of a prefab kind of group, which isn't the truth. And it's a blessing and a curse. Being called a boy band is a blessing because girls adore you all over the planet, and you have fun with it, and you get to travel all over the world and sell records and do great things. But at the same time, the credibility factor is a little bit lessened by the fact that you're quote unquote a boy band.
Yeah.
So we did take our lumps, but we were also blessed at the same time. Blessing and a curse.
Got it. Totally makes sense. And like I said, when I walked in here, I said, oh my God, they sound amazing. I think it's one of these things where we as the public get so used to when you hear somebody on the radio, they sound really, really great. But a lot of times when you hear them live, maybe not so good, or there's all of this other music, background music, and that's not you guys. You really are the real thing.
Well, we've always prided ourselves on our vocals, and, you know, when you're doing an acoustic set and it's just literally you and the guitar, or just an a cappella set and it's just our voices together, that's when you're really able to show what you can do. So that's why when they talked about doing this set, we're like, yeah, we'll do it acoustic, absolutely. I mean, that's part of the way that you dispel those conversations about whether you can sing and what your credibility should be. You know, and I think just this kind of what we started doing together. We started singing harmony, and so for us getting back together and doing it again, it's like riding a bike.
So why now? Why 10 years later? Because you guys all kind of had your own things going on. You know, Justin, I know you've ran for mayor here, and we interviewed tons, and you know, you guys all have had your own reality shows or participated in different things. Why now, 10 years later?
I think we missed it. I mean, I think that was the biggest thing. We missed it, and the fans missed it. And I think the support and the kind of the campaigning of the fans for us to get back together was probably the biggest driving force. But, you know, truth be told, we never broke up. We always intended on doing another record together. It just became an issue of us kind of lining our schedules up and everyone having the time to do it. And now you see the kind of pop music scene has come back around, and boy bands are reinventing themselves, and new ones are coming on the scene. So I think it was the combination of a few factors. One, our schedule. Two, the fans really campaigning for it. And three, the timing being right for us to come back and do this.
Did you fear at all, do you fear at all, because you're really now just launching this, that it wouldn't be a success? Was there ever a fear of coming back and taking, more lumps, as you say?
I mean, I think that there's always a fear. You never know, what's going to happen. Are the fans still going to be there? They're going to like the new music. But I think that the support has been incredible. And I personally feel just very comfortable and confident. I think the fans are going to love the new music. We're going to have a great time on an amazing tour with some of the biggest artists of all times. And so we're in a great place to be.
Yeah, I think the fact that we're on a tour that's virtually already sold out in 47, started with 25 dates and now it's 47 because the demand was so high. Our reunion's already a success. I mean, us getting back together, reconnecting, getting our bond stronger again, and being on this tour, that's already a success. So the success of Microphone and the album 2.0, that's just bonus. But we made a record that we all like, that we're proud of, and we think our fans will as well. But at the end of the day, we're having fun doing it.
Over the years, I wondered if I was going to see one of you guys out on your own. That if you were going to break away, Beyonce broke away and Justin Timberlake broke away. Was there ever a point where you guys considered it, or did you kind of make a pact that we're going to stick together if we come back?
Well, honest.
We all did our own thing, and that was when Drew mentioned earlier that it was time to take a break and step back and pursue personal things. I mean, we all did that. For Justin, it was largely in a political forum. Drew did Dancing with the Stars. I did two solo records.
Stripped in the Chippendales.
He didn't strip. He didn't strip.
He also did solo records.
You are fit.
So, I think everyone took the time to do and pursue the things they wanted to do with the understanding that we would come back together and do what we love to do and do it again. And that's why we're here, in 2013 doing what we love to do all over again.
Okay, so when I'm telling all the girls that I know and, a lot of the younger girls in my office wanted to be like my producer today and come and be with you guys.
You should have brought them.
I know. I was definitely had the hot assignment today. So a lot of them, were saying, okay, you've got to ask them that this song is far different, I think, than the Microphone is far different than the songs that you were singing 10, 15 years ago. Far more suggestive. Little metaphor maybe thrown in there. So did you do that purposely?
Yeah, what's she doing?
Yeah.
I have no idea what you mean. It's about singing technique.
No, but honestly, you guys are...
The girls in your office got to get their minds out of the gutter. This is appalling.
Did you make a conscious decision that we're going to be a little bit more edgy this time around?
No, we made a conscious decision to find the best songs we possibly could. And this song, when we heard it, just the beat, the melody, catchy. Everything about it is a catchy, catchy song. And, we didn't dwell on, this and that. It was just kind of, this is a great song. We're going to record it. We recorded a lot of great songs. And that just so happened to be the one that stood out to everybody saying, that is a hit. That is our first single. So it wasn't this conscious, we have to recreate ourselves and brand ourselves in a different way. We've always recorded up-tempos. We've always recorded more R&B leaning stuff. They just haven't been our singles. This just so happens to be one of the first singles, other than Una Noche, which had a Latin feel, to come out. And music's changed since we were out. Music has become much more forward, suggestive, but also production's changed. The technique for recording's changed. The harmony aspect has changed. So either we hold on to what we did in the past and, live by the sword, die by that sword, or we change with the times and we kind of take our sound and reinvent it and make it current. And that's what we decided to do.
And as an artist, you always want to keep growing. So I think that, that's mostly what we wanted to do. We wanted to not change ourselves, but we wanted to just go to the next level.
Did you have anything that you wanted to add to it, Jeff? It seemed like you were going to chime in.
No, I was listening. Drew so eloquently put it in the right way. I mean, I think that the song does have some edge to it. But truth be told, I mean, look, we're regular guys and we're the boys next door. But we do all have a little bit of edge to us, you know, regardless. So
yes,
it definitely suits, the song does suit us. What'd you say?
I said, yes, Mr. Chippendale.
Yeah, as a stripper, microphone is perfect song for my comeback.
How does it feel? I mean, obviously, you know, women all over the country love you guys. I think are so clearly, as you were saying, Drew, with the fact that this tour sold out so quickly and that you're extending it, that women and we had some guys in the room, too, that were kind of, you know, humming along. Really looking forward to you guys coming back. But what is it like to come back here to Cincinnati? I mean, I know, Drew, you live here. You never left either, correct? I mean, you live here as well, Justin. So for you guys to perform in front of a Cincinnati audience like you're going to do here in a couple of weeks, what is that like for you guys?
I mean, there's nothing like being in your hometown and having the support that we get here. It's just, I mean, even if we hadn't had the success we've had, you know, across around the country and around the world, you know, having the kind of love that we get here in Cincinnati, you just can't replace that.
And you can almost feel a sense of pride that they have, that we're all Ohio boys, and they can claim us. You know, they can say, "Oh, you know, they're from Cincinnati, they're from Ohio." So I mean, there's a palpable connection that you feel with the audiences here in your hometown. That you know, they enjoy what you do, but they also have the sense of pride. You know, the same way we talk about, you know, George Clooney, or we talk about, you know, Carmen Electra, Sarah Jessica Parker, the other Cincinnati natives. Everybody claims, you know, oh yeah, you know, it's there's a sense of pride of being one of those that people claim.
We talked about this when we met last week, that a lot of them, though, they don't live here. You guys still live here. And I heard when you guys were performing and they were doing the Q&A, everybody was asking, are you going to eventually move back here? I know that you have a home right next to Drew's, but will you live here permanently?
100%, yeah. No, I really value the way that I was brought up and the surroundings and, you know, being here in Cincinnati. It's a great place to grow up, and so I definitely want to raise my family here. There's no question.
Yeah. What is it, you think?
It's the chili. I mean, you just can't get it anywhere else. It's not the same.
It is the chili, isn't it? Forgive me, Jeff, where do you live now?
I live outside of Las Vegas, but I am also originally from Ohio. And there is something to be said about the Midwest mentality, the vibe, the people, all that stuff. I mean, you move to those places like L.A., New York, Nashville, Miami, whatever, for opportunities to get into the entertainment business. But there still is no place like the Midwest. There are no people like Midwestern people. And, you know, I'm obviously partial to it, but, you know, hopefully someday I'll be able to get back here with my family as well.
Yeah, yeah. Four kids, one child, two. Justin, what's up?
I'm still working on it.
He's a kid at heart. You know?
Justin, are you single?
I am single, yes.
So we can put out the signal
the
for
call.
All the girls.
No, desperately looking. Call.
It's like the Batman beacon. Yeah. Justin's back.
The Justin beacon.
He's out.
Yeah. Okay, I want to have some fun. Will you guys have? Well, let me ask one more thing. Drew, we were talking about this last week. Okay, so you guys are going on this big tour. Then what? Are we going to get more of you guys? Are you going to continue to stay together, or is this going to be it?
I think, you know, I mean, I certainly hope so. I think we have all left the possibility open, and I think mostly we're just ready to go out and have fun with the present and this new album and the new tour. And, I think that there's a real good chance we'll be sticking around and doing a whole lot more.
Depends how much Justin annoys us on the road. We'll revisit it at the end of the tour.
You're giving me a News 5 exclusive.
As long as their wives are willing to let them go out on the road, then we'll be out there.
This is going to be different. I mean, you guys touched on this before. You guys were all single. I mean, I know you maybe had significant others in that, but you're touring around, you're young, you're teenagers, early 20s. Now you have kids and families, big families. What is this going to be like?
It's going to be different, but it's going to be that much more special because, you know, we have all these memories that we shared among the four of us, but now we have our own families that we can share them with, you know, and bring our wives and our kids out. And they'll have these memories. You know, these are, I mean, we took camping trips and trips over the summer when we were kids, and I remember them. So this is going to be our kids' version of getting in the camper and, you know, going to Michigan. You know, it's just going to happen to be a
very nice camper.
Nice tour bus. Nice tour bus. And we're,
driver.
You know, yeah, Daddy doesn't have to drive. you know, so it really is kind of going to be our family vacation for the summer.
Kids are coming, wives are coming.
Yeah.
All right. We'll work on this for you. We might get you a date. We might get you somebody before the tour kicks off.
I
have a feeling you're not having a hard time with that. When Drew and I were talking, I said, you know, if you guys were like the Smurfs or Dwarfs or something, like, what would your title?
Drew's a dwarf.
No, I love Drew. I didn't have to stand on a box next to Drew like I normally have to with anybody.
Yeah.
Okay, are you ready?
Thanks.
So if we had to talk about who's social Smurf? Who's social Smurf?
Justin. Social Smurf.
Who's insomnia Smurf?
That'd be me.
This is an easy one. Sporty Smurf.
That's actually tough. These guys are all sports fanatics. Are they all sports? That'd be a tough call.
That's you.
Daddy.
Nick probably the most.
Yeah, he follows sports.
But it's by a slim margin.
Drew says that if he was a Smurf or a dwarf, that it would be either detail Smurf or meticulous Smurf.
He is and always will be grumpy Smurf. We've said that from day one. He's grumpy Smurf. Don't let him put this meticulous thing in there.
Is he grumpy? Are you grumpy? Smurf.
Only around them. Nor that really happy-go-lucky. But you put me in a room with them, and you know.
I would say meticulous is a good word to describe.
Well, you weren't grumpy with me at all.
Exactly.
Yeah.
It's them. They
it's
bring
pretty
out
hard
the worst
to be grumpy with you.
Yeah, all right.
Bring out the worst in me.
But if you had to like for one of you guys, is there a bad boy of the group still?
Everybody is fighting for the best.
Well, Justin wins definitely by default at this point.
Yeah, you better say that. Your wives are like, you better say that. Okay. Most of you guys Midwest guys. Three of you guys are Cincinnati guys. Do you love your Skyline chili?
Heck yeah.
Absolutely.
Cincinnati chili.
Oh, me too. Do you love La Rosa's?
Oh, absolutely.
You used to work there, right, Nick?
I did. I used to make pizzas at La
Rosa's. What about your favorite TV station? Do you like Channel 5?
Everybody loves Channel 5.
I think we like Channel 5.
It just so happens
that like Channel 5.
It's all about Channel 5.
Channel 5 sunshine. One, two, three.
You're my sunshine after the rain. You're the cure against my fear and my pain. 'Cause I'm losing my mind when you're not around. It's all because of you.
Oh, I love you guys.
I love you too.
You guys rock.
You don't need to take
you guys are the best. Okay.